Okay, so the first thing you're going to notice is that I am in my car. Now, here's what's funny about this. There's a couple of things I want to talk about. First of all, I hate it when people talk to their camera or their phone in the car like they just got done with CrossFit and they had this amazing insight. And, you know, I get that it's me just being cynical, but I think what's funny is here I am in my car talking to you. So let me just call out a couple things. One, it is raining out. And two, there's a lot of work going on in my house. And so it would be very disruptive if I was speaking to you and you heard all this pounding and sawing and cutting. And number three, I want to get this to you and I am committed to getting it to you. So this is one of those situations where I'm not going for perfect, I'm going for done. So there's a lot of good stuff in that. So hey everybody, this is RC Peck and this is my weekly investment thought. And I've got this idea, and it's not a new idea if you've been following me for a while, but it's an idea that I think can bring a lot of clarification to what is happening with your money. And here's the deal. Simple is really hard. Simple is a very difficult thing to do, regardless of whatever you're doing, but especially when there's a lot of things on the line, like your future and your future stability and your future steadiness and economic stability, right? That's a lot on the line when you invest. So what we do is we think we're doing what's best. And I want to talk about Bruce Lee for a second because he really went up against the status quo in a big way. He saw that a lot of martial arts were only good in certain situations where maybe you shouldn't do a kick in that situation, but they only teach kicking in that situation. So he started his own martial arts, Jeet Kune Do. And the idea behind that was just do what works. Just do what works. Keep it simple, but just do what works. And one of his most repeated quotes is, he does not fear the man who has practiced 10,000 different kicks. He fears the man who's practiced one kick 10,000 times. And the idea is get really good at what matters most. Get really good at it. Now, in the case of me in investing, I have two questions that I ask. Not one question, but two questions. Now, the thing about that is the first question, you probably don't even need to ask the second one because the first one pretty much defines 90% whether you're going to win or lose the game of investing. But here's the point, and one of the points I want to make is what side of complexity are you on? Because sometimes I ask people, I don't ask it directly, but I basically say, where are you? Is your approach simple? And what they describe is a simple plan before complexity, right? And I think about Van Gogh or Picasso. You look at Picasso's early work and super skilled artist. You look at his work, but you see work that's like every other single artist like him at the time. There's no differentiation. And it's interesting, right? Where you start off with your peers. You start off with what else is going around you and you want to mimic that. But then as you look at Picasso's career, it evolves. And you can tell there's this point where he passes through complexity and he's on the other side of complexity, kind of sophistication, simple sophistication. I had to think of the word sophistication, right? And then you look at those paintings and you're like, oh, that's the Picasso I know. He figured it out. He was in real simplicity, powerful simplicity. The same thing for Van Gogh. You look at Van Gogh's early work, and it's like every other painter during his time. It doesn't really look that different. It's beautiful. It's difficult. Most people couldn't do it, but there were hundreds or thousands of other people who could do it, and there was no differentiation between Van Gogh's early work and really anyone else's. But then when you look at his later work, especially right up till he dies, you go, oh, that's a Van Gogh. Yeah, that's a Van Gogh. He figured it out, right? He had gone through the work. He had gone through the work of complexity. And he finally said, oh, this is simplicity. This is the best way to communicate what works. And what I fight for most with people, not fight with most people, but what I fight most for people is to find that elegant simplicity, that powerful simplicity, the simply powerful way of investing. Because when you find that simply powerful way, it's really hard to break. Now, the thing is, it doesn't market well. It doesn't sell well. And the reason I'm having this conversation with you is because this morning I was talking to a new client of mine. And I call them John Templeton clients, because John Templeton figured out early on in his life that he could come up with the strategy, but he realized he couldn't fulfill it. He couldn't implement it. It was too scary for him. And I was talking to this client about how the brilliance of John Templeton wasn't that he came up with the strategy to invest. And he died being worth $22 billion in his late 80s, so he clearly had figured it out. But his brilliance was noticing that he wasn't going to implement it, that he had to have someone else implement it. So even with a simple approach, what's nice about having a simple approach is if you can't implement a simple approach, now most men will shame themselves and say, I should be able to, I have to be able to, but that's just the shaming thing they do. But really the brilliance is when you have a simple approach and you realize you can't implement it, then it's really clear that you need somebody else to implement it, or you need to go through a training to shift your behavior so you actually can implement it. But until you have that simple approach, you'll never know whether you can or not. And that's why I rail against, right, the pick of the month newsletter industry, because they're giving you 30, 40 ticker symbols to invest in, and then they give you a new one each week or each month, and then you got to trade out and trade in. And science is very clear that the conscious brain can only handle 7 things at once, plus or minus 2. And I'll say this to you, when that conscious brain is under stress, like the market is falling really fast, then the conscious brain cannot handle 7 things at once, plus or minus 2. It probably can handle maybe 2 things or 1 thing. And the idea is to build a system so when you're the least resourceful, you're at your best. And that's how elegant simplicity, powerful simplistic ways of approaching investing is really where the power is for people's future and stability and freedom. It's finding that. So thank you so much for being in my world. And this is just another step in helping you protect your portfolio and your future. And hey guys, if you found this conversation of value, please go ahead and like, share, and forward it, because it makes a difference. Okay, everybody, thanks so much. And I will speak to you next time, probably not in my car, but really get it done. Get it done is better than having it perfect. And this was also about getting it done. And today it was about getting it done in the car while it's raining with construction going on in the house. You guys are great. Thank you for being in my world. Take care.